things behind me that I'm going to be showing throughout the conversation today. So let me know if you can hear me and see me. I'm Diane Cunningham. I'm going to start us off with prayer. Hi, Brenda. Good morning. I'm going to start us off with some prayer. We're going to talk today about getting things done. I've got a lot of things to hold up and show you, and I'm going to run around my office. Some other webinars that you've been on maybe are not like this. This is like the Diane Cunningham show, and you never know what's going to go on over here. So we have a lot of fun, and it's not your average webinar. Hi, Marcia. Hi, Daphne. Welcome, everybody. I'm going to go ahead and pray us in. Hi, Shelly. Hi, Rhonda. So let's do this. All right. Father God, thank you so much for this time together today. Thank you for my cat, Xander, who's running through my office right now at this moment. Lord, thank you just that we can show up. Lord, thank you that technology is working right now. And Lord, today we're talking about getting things done. And Lord, for me, that means the more that I do what you've asked me to do and show up and do the next right thing, Lord, you can then do what you need to do with my work. Some of it goes straight into the garbage can, and some goes out into the world, and I don't know which things are going to be used the most, and I don't know which things are, so I need to know. And Lord, that if they just get one tiny nugget that they can use in the next 24 hours, then praise God, hallelujah. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen. Yay, and fun, fun, fun. So who's ready to learn something new? Go ahead and just type into the box. We were adding people here. If you're ready to learn something, just say, we always do like a high five. I can't see you right now, but I can hear you basically typing into the room. If you're ready to learn something new, just say, yes, I'm willing, I'm open. I'm ready, God. I'm ready, send me. Okay, and you know what? I'm just here to provide what has worked for me. If it works for you, great. If not, throw it out. Hello. Okay, so let's just let that be. You've got to find your own systems. You've got to find your own systems. So as we are in here, let's go ahead and introduce ourselves. Why don't you type into the chat box really quick, because I've got a lot of teaching to do. Let me tell you where we are. This is the National Association of Christian Women Entrepreneurs. See, this is my home office, but why don't you to type into the box your name and your location. So we've got Teresa, and we've got lots of others here in the room. So just tell us who you are and where you live, okay, as we're getting started. This is me. That's me holding my torch, and that's upstairs right now. It's the torch I made for myself, and I am the president and founder of the National Association of Christian Women Entrepreneurs. And all of those of you that are members, go ahead and say, yay, I am a member. I am an NACWE sister. Awesome. I'm a coach, mentor. I'm an author of 6 books now, soon to be 7, 8, hopefully a 9. I've got a series of 3 that I'm working on this year. Yep, crazy. I am a fun friend. I am a coffee addict, a leader, a woman of God. Cheers to the coffee addiction. And a woman of God, risk taker, speaker, teacher, connector, Be Brave Today Girl, marathon runner, plane crash survivor. Mm-hmm. Just had my 5-year plane crash survivor anniversary. And I am an artist. Yay. I love to paint and create and color, and I have a whole new bunch of fresh ideas from that. As we're going along today, if you're a tweeter, tweet, and you can do that at NACWE, the hashtag NACWE, but more importantly, we're starting conversations at NACWE Chat. And I don't have that on the screen, but maybe Kim can type that in for us. So we've got 19 in the house right now, and I know more are going to be coming. We're talking today about getting things done. Cha-ching! We're talking about getting things done, moving the envelope, how to take action, move things forward, and be productive to create programs, write books, and offer events. Who wants to do that? Do you need to create some products or programs? Do you need to write some books? Hello, and do you need to offer events? Everybody just say yes. Say yes. If you have not done any of these things, that's okay. You will. And you might do all of these things this year. You might do all of these things in the next 90 days. How about that? How about that? You can do that because it's about moving forward. It's about taking action. So, again, this is NACWE hosted. A lot of our sisters are here in the house. It is all about connecting. I want you to talk during class here. So you all are talking right here in the class. That's good. We want you to do that because that's a part of how we get together. Real quick, couple commercial announcements. At NACWE, our mission is to train, empower, and inspire Christian women as they build their entrepreneurial business. We do this in three ways, the three C's: connect, create, and collaborate. We connect through our private forums, teleclasses, and webinars. Hello, right here. Live events coming up in 23 days. I think that's the number. And virtual events. And we create so many things together by idea sharing, by our virtual networking that we do now, our vision casting, and we collaborate. I work with you, you work with me, I refer to you, you refer to me. That's how we do it. It's how we do it. We walk side by side. Our expert for this month is a cool new chick we found that I am excited about. I just ordered her book, Rock Your To-Do List. This is her brand new book off the press. It just came out last week. Rock Your To-Do List. Get to your biggest goals faster with less stress in only 15 minutes a day. So the book should be here at my house tomorrow. Cannot wait to bring her on. So only members get to come to our expert trainings like this. So every single month. So you're going to want to join us. I'm going to have a special offer invitation for you if you're not a member to come and join us by tomorrow night. So stay tuned to hear about that. A lot of you are already members. So we're inviting the ones that are not to come on. Come on. So one of the cool things also that we've added is our membership directory. And so this is just a picture of some of those gals that are part of our membership, and we can't wait to add you as well. Oh, yeah. Okay, 23 days from now is when we've got room for five more of you. Five more. If you're coming, there's a lot of you in the room that are coming to Dallas in 23 days. So if you're already coming, just say, I'm there. I'm coming. Dallas, here I come. So go ahead and just type that into the box for me. Because we have a whole group of you already coming, but I think we have about five seats left, and so that's where you're going to want to take some serious action in the next 24 hours to 48 hours so that we can have a seat saved for you. Amen. So a lot of women are so excited. They've been waiting for months and months for this event to happen, and every year we plan these. We've been doing our national conferences every year, except for the 2 years after my divorce. And so we've gathered together. Those 2 years, I was recovering. I was regrouping. We did virtual conferences. But every year, I take the action. I sign the contract. I put it on the calendar, and I invite you to come. So I cannot wait to see who else takes action. Okay, let's get things done. Here we go. You guys ready? All right. It's about focusing. Let me pause. Does everybody have a piece of paper to take notes? This is where I've got to get you on board here. Does everybody have a piece of paper, take notes, pens, highlighters, whatever you need? I've got probably, let's just show the truth of the matter here. You know, some of us have pen addictions. This is not even all of them. I've got like three or four or five of these little cups filled. If you have a pen addiction, paper addiction, just go ahead and say yes. Mm-hmm. Yep. A whole tablet. Woo-hoo! Yay for the pen addicts. Okay, focus, time, productivity, and organization. Like I said before, if you've never been on one of our webinars, watch out. We have some fun, and you know, why be boring on a webinar? I have finally learned over these years and years to stop trying to be somebody else. And I finally learned to just be Diane. If you don't hear anything else from me, if you click off and you get kicked off this webinar, or you don't like me anymore, I want you to hear this one thing, sister. Be you. Be you. Stop trying to be Marcia. I'm not Marcia. I'm Diane. Marcia needs to be Marcia. Daphne is going to be Daphne. She rocks at being Daphne. Deb rocks at being Deb. Donna needs to be Donna, because you know what? You all bring your stuff, your experience, strength, and hope. You bring that. You bring that. And you know what? I can't bring that. I need to be Diane. And this is Diane, full force, unplugged, rocking the house here. So let's do this. Focus, time, productivity, organization. Woo! We asked, and you answered. So here's what happens for us. You know what? We have a training every single month. We chart those here. That's how I keep track. But I ask you guys what you need to learn, and then I teach that. Okay? I teach you what you ask me to learn. Why is that? Because you need to ask your tribe. Here's another side note for you. You need to ask your tribe what they want to learn, and then you teach them that. I mean, it's kind of a miracle, isn't it? You ask them what they want, and you teach them that. See, it works. Okay, so we asked you what you wanted, and I was totally shocked at the answers. In fact, I have a file folder here where I keep track of all the answers. Everything needs to go in a file folder, my friends, or a three-ring binder. Okay, so we asked what you needed, and you chose organization, focus, and getting things done. It wasn't about how to do social media. That got some answers. It wasn't about how to do videos or offer programs or create a product. It wasn't anything about that. Okay? Yes, ask and provide. Ask, seek, knock. All right. So let's start out with the three A's. Then we're going to get into the seven get it done tricks. And then I'm going to share my five boundary miracles. Okay? So keep on keeping on here. The first A is awareness. Okay? Write these things down, sisters. So the first A that you need to have in any of this is awareness, okay? And this goes for every part of your life, every part of your life. So awareness, what does that mean for me? That means I need to have awareness in my body. I need to have awareness in my mental capacity. I need to have awareness in my time. I need to have awareness. And it's that awareness, sometimes we avoid it. There's another A for you. Sometimes we don't want to see the truth. Sometimes we're uncomfortable. Sometimes we don't want to feel the feeling, okay? It's that awareness that has helped me to go from 203 pounds down to in the 160s, okay? Because I get on the scale every morning, and I'm aware of how much I weigh, and I'm aware of how much I eat. It's that awareness that's helped me to track all of my numbers with my business, to actually act like a businesswoman, and to see in my money log. You know, I keep track every single day of how much comes in, okay? Because if I'm not bringing in any income, guess what? I don't have a business. Just saying. If you don't bring in any money, you don't have a business. You have an expensive hobby, okay? So I'm sorry to break the truth to you here, but you got to have some awareness. You've got to have some awareness in your business. You've got to have some awareness in your time. Where is your time going? So, as we go along, you guys, who's taking notes? Who's here with me? Okay, I'm going to be calling you out. We've got a lot more people that jumped in the call. So, awareness, okay? So, if any of this rings your bell, ding, 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 dong, I need you to tell me that in the room, okay? So, we need to have awareness of where we are, who we are, what our issues are, good, bad, and ugly. Then we need to have some accountability, okay? Now, this is the other key piece. And we're going to be talking about this throughout the webinar. Once we have the awareness, well, accountability, you know, that can come from having a sponsor that I go meet with. That can come from my coach, which I meet with tomorrow. My accountability can come from going to the Weight Watchers and standing on the scale. So accountability comes in all ways for me. How do you get your accountability? That's the second really crucial A. Because, you know what, like you guys told me in the poll, because the question I asked was organization, focus, and getting things done, and you basically said, I get overwhelmed and distracted. I know what I'm supposed to do, but I don't do it, okay? You know what you're supposed to do. Let me ask you this hard question. Do you know what you're supposed to do, and do you not get it done? Because of fear, because of overwhelm, because you're trying to get it to be so perfect, do you know what you're supposed to be doing and you don't get it done? Okay, so this is where the rubber meets the road here. Do you know what you're supposed to be doing, or do you get so overwhelmed with, I mean, I have a giant pile of stuff. I have a huge, you know, we've got a conference coming up, and I have lots and lots of things to get done. Will I get them done? You bet. And the third A is action, okay? The third A is action. So we've got the awareness, and then we need some accountability, and then the only thing that's going to change anything for you is action. Action. If you don't get out the door to go walk, run, exercise, dance down the street, skip, you know, hula hoop, I don't care what you do. If you don't take some action, that's a verb. Hello. If I don't write the thing down on the calendar, is it going to get done? No, probably not. Because you know what? It's going to spin around up here and like land somewhere else. Action. Action speaks, sister. Action, action, action. So I'm a girl of action. Sometimes that gets me into big trouble because that's my highest gifting on the StrengthsFinder. If you don't know your StrengthsFinder top five, take it. Take it quickly. Take it now. Take the action. Because if you know your top five, it's going to help you to move in those directions. And so sometimes we take action too quickly. But I would tend to think most of us tend to not take action. Do you think you're an action taker? Here's where you do a self-assessment. Do you think you're an action taker, or do you think you hold back out of fear or out of procrastination or out of perfectionism? So this is where you got to tell your own truth. I don't know. I don't know all of you. I know some of you, and I think I can probably help you with that diagnosis, but do you need to take more action? Do you need to take more action? And it looks like there's a lot of the fear that's holding everybody back. Yes. I've got huge piles of fear. One of the things we're going to do at the conference is a fear inventory. I mean, every day I have all this fear. Fear, lots of fear. And so we've got to just own it, talk about it, deal with it, write it on a piece of paper, and then take some more action. Okay? All right. Action, action. Let's dive in some more. So this is where we're going to take some check notes. Check. And commitment. Commitment. You know, really, some of us are afraid of commitment. We don't want to think we are because, you know, that seems like it's got a little bad, you know, bad vibe to it. When you're doing a webinar, drink water. That's my commitment to myself. Commit. You know, if I didn't commit actually 3.5 years ago to do one of these webinars every single month, I didn't know I was going to be doing them every single month for 3.5 years. I made the commitment to do one every month. Okay, I've also made the commitment to be sober, but I'm just doing that one day at a time. You know, one day at a time. I can get till tonight just for today without taking a drink. Okay, and I've done that for many days now. So it's about the commitment. It's about choosing, how will I live today? What am I going to do for my business today? How am I going to move forward so that I can serve the people? Remember this. How can I, if I don't get on this webinar and do and teach you what I've learned, I'm not serving the world, I'm not using my gifts, I'm not passing it forward. So if you're sitting over there in perfectionism, you're not passing forward, you're not owning the gifts that God has given you. Own the gift. This is it. God has given each of you a gift. I see it coming here in the heart. It's a shingle. And it's our heart, and it's our heart message, and it's what we have to teach, learn, and share. If I don't teach it to you, if I don't meet with you, if I don't coach you, if I just hold it all to myself, that's really dishonoring my Father. That's dishonoring my Father. Can I get an amen? High five in the house. We each have 24 hours. I've got 24. You've got 24. Some of you have children. Some of you have aging parents that you take care of. Some of you have little tiny people called children that live in your home. Some of you have, I know people that have 6 children, a part-time job, a husband, all these pets. You know what? We all have 24 hours. We all have 24. What will you do with yours? What will you do with yours? What are you doing with yours, and how do you need to shift it? What do you need to change about your 24 hours? What one tiny thing could change? Okay? My tricks to get things done. You guys ready? This is where I need you to take some notes. What my tricks. So, get it done trick number one. Here we go. It's the Diane Cunningham show. The timer trick. You guys have all heard me talk about this a million times, but there might be somebody new here. And so we always assume there's new people on every webinar. Why is that? Because who's here for the first time on one of my webinars? Let's see the number. Who's here for the first time on one of my webinars? There she is. There she is, Teresa. Kate's here for the second time. Who's here for, Karen's been here a million times. Kim's been here a million times. Who else is here for the first time? We got Therese is here for the first time. Who else is here for the first time? Anita Hall. All you first timers, you rock, okay? And the reason we tell the story again, the reason we tell our story again is because there's going to be someone here that's never heard the story. Okay, you get that? Everybody with me? High five. Okay, get it done. Trick number one is the timer trick. This is a very simple, I call it Taylor. She's my friend. It's not Taylor Swift. Well, maybe it is Taylor Swift. But it's Taylor, and this is how I get things done. I set the timer. Imagine that. I set the timer. And this is for things that I want to do. More importantly, it's for things I need to do, and sometimes it's things I don't want to do. Okay, what do I mean by that? Well, I don't get into like doing taxes and that kind of thing. I'm not a numbers girl. So if I need to sit down and do taxes, you better believe I'm going to set this and say, okay, Diane, you can do it for 60 minutes. Or let's say I've got a guest bedroom. It's like totally out of control. It's filled with conference stuff and gifts and supplies. But guess what? My dad is coming to visit me next week. My dad. And so I've got to like deal with that. So I set the timer. Set the timer, sister. Set the timer. All you have to do is get a little time. You probably have a timer. Who has a timer? Do you have a timer? You probably have a couple timers. Yes, you have one on your phone too. I am old school. Look at me. I use a timer separate than my phone. Mm-hmm. And I use an old school little calculator. I carry it in my purse. You know what? Because I own a business. It makes a difference to me. Okay, get it done. Trick number one, timer trick. So just set the timer and do it in short bursts. So lots of times I'll give myself an hour. I don't need 5 hours to write a blog. Do you? I need an hour maybe to write a blog. I need an hour to get a newsletter done. Probably less than that, honestly. I've been doing a writing series, and I'll tell you more about this later. But it's pretty amazing. I can write 750 words in about 15 minutes. Do I need to edit later? Yes. Please, please, please write this down. Do not edit before you've written a word. Okay? Write it down. Do not edit. Do not pre-edit. Somebody type that into the box. You are over-editing yourself. You're editing before you've written anything. You're editing before you've even like launched. You've already told yourself that no one's signing up for the program, okay? And you haven't even written the program or told us about the program, okay? So get it done. Get it done, trick number one. Get it done, trick number two. Race myself, trick. Race myself. Lots of times, so you'll laugh, but this is how I do stuff. So I will, like, every morning, sometimes this is one of the pages, I think, from last week or yesterday, I don't know, before 5, okay? Doesn't matter what's written on there. Like, I'll say, okay, Diane, before 12, you got to get all this stuff done. Before 5, okay, before the end of the weekend. So this is what I call this race myself trick. I don't know, I just made that name up yesterday. Because, like, maybe I get 3 of those things done out of 7, but that's more than I would have done before. So give yourself like a little time limit and see how many of the things you can get done. I race myself. Nobody is telling me what to do when. I work for myself. So it's all about me giving myself some extra dose of motivation. Okay? Get it done, trick number 3, rough draft. And this goes back to what we just said about right now, edit later. I tell all my clients that we're writing a rough draft. Okay? You're writing a rough draft of your sales page. You're writing a rough draft of your mission statement. You're writing a rough draft of this email that's going to go out. Because you know what? You are. It is a rough draft. Don't freak yourself out. Okay? Who needs to just really own this rough draft trick? Because you know what? Sometimes we get so afraid to write on the piece of paper. You know, I don't want to ruin the paper. I don't want to ruin the journal. I don't want to ruin my calendar planner system. Yes, you do. Ruin it. Ruin it. Write a rough draft. Write a rough draft, okay? That's trick number 3. Work backwards. Work backwards. You'll see, let's see. Oh, okay, I'm not going to run over there right now, but that is all a working backwards trick right there. So what do I mean when I say that? Everything you have planned, every launch you're doing, every book launch, every program you're offering, every event, every retreat. So over there on that board, I have the next Brave book. which I'm going to invite NACWI members to be a part of, my next collaboration book. We did rock bottom. We rocked rock bottom, in fact, and now we're going to rock brave. Okay? So, yeah, we've got the Brave book, working backwards on that. We've got Catch on Fire Conference, working backwards from that. We've got the Hard Art Retreat coming up. Next one is in October, working backwards, meaning what do I need to do to promote that? What do I need to do to send out emails? What do I need to do on the website page? What needs to change with graphics? What do I need to do? Do I need to get a new book cover designed? Yeah, you bet. So basically, the working backwards. So that helps us get things done, doesn't it? Does this help you get things done? I'm sure you all do this, but we're just like calling it out. Nothing here on this webinar is going to be rocket science, sister. It's just a matter of reminding yourself of how to get things done. Who else needs reminders? I have reminders all around my office telling me that I am proud of myself for fill in the blank. What do you have in front of you in your office? Let's just do a little side note here. Do you have love notes to yourself? Do you have love notes to yourself? I have a sign up here that says, I'm a creative machine. Okay. I have a sign down here that says, I'm willing to receive love, miracles, blessings, serenity. I'm willing to receive all of that. What love notes do you have for yourself? Let's see, what else? I've got so many love notes right here. It's good. It's good. I believe in you right there. Simplify. So keep track. Like, write yourself some love notes. Write them. Put them everywhere. Write some love notes and encouragement to you. Don't give it all away. Give some to you. Give some to you. Amen. Yes. Oops. I think I'm... Yep. There we go. Okay. Get it done trick. All right. See it big. See it big. Okay. So what do I mean when I say this? Well, for me, lots of time... I mean, I have a whole room that's an office. If you don't have a whole room, if you have a little tiny closet, use the closet. If you have just a little cube in a corner, use the corner. Doesn't matter how big you have, just use it. You get it? So see it big. Use big post-its, okay? Use big charts. I write everything down, and I'm going to get up, so pardon me here. I have a huge, I just got this for like $25. It's a giant big dry erase board that was on the clearance down at the Hobby Lobby. We love Hobby Lobby. And then look at all these. These are little notes and giant post-its for me to remember things for the conference. Activities we're going to do, teaching lessons, topics, gifts, songs, exercises. Yay! And then here, this is the brain board, okay? And so we're going to talk about that in just a minute. But don't be afraid. You know, this is why we had a little conversation. I can't have my calendar on here. I can't see that thing. I have a giant calendar here, a planner, 8.5 by 11, giant, like in a three-ring binder. And I have things on. I have a big calendar on the wall here. Most of you have already seen that, but let's go ahead and just do a little show and tell. Oopsie. See? Big calendar on the wall. Yes. Hello. Okay. We're having a moment. We are having a live moment. See it big. Hold on. All the cords. Oh, golly. Here we are. Yep. Yeah, that's how we're going to do it today. We're going to be crazy like that. Okay, hold on, everybody. Guys still with me? Oh, I love it. Hold on. Okay. Woo! Mm-hmm. Okay, are you guys having fun or are you like getting dizzy? Okay, this is not working. Okay, so we're just going to hold this. How's that? Okay. And one more reason why I need to go over and get the big old Mac, the Big Mac, the Mac Daddy, because this little Surface Pro and my little system here is just not working for me this moment. Okay, hold on, everybody. Okay, is that okay? Oh, gosh. Breathe. Ah, ah. Everybody still here? You guys, we'll just say that this has never happened on a webinar, but you know, I was trying to just be in the moment. Okay, so let's continue on. I'm going to breathe and have a moment with myself. Thank you, Lord. Okay, see a big trick. So we've talked about that. Hello. So maybe I should just stand up. Maybe I'll be more on the screen. Okay, so let's talk about the brain board. Yes, let's take a sip of water. Anybody else need a sip of water? Callie's going to come over. Callie's going to come over and help me. I know. Drive on up, sister. I need a little purging moment. Oh, let's have coffee too. Okay, we're all going to have a coffee sip and a water sip. I think I might be spilling coffee. And we will get back on track, I promise. You guys believe me, right? Those of you that have been here before, you know, this is like totally off the chain. Okay. Woo! All right, the brain board. Yeah, I do drink all that water, Anita. I drink a lot. Lots and lots and lots. Okay. Woo! Okay, so here's the brain board. Here's the brain board. Here's the brain board big. Here's the brain board big. Okay, everybody see this? So I'm just gonna, you can see it on the screen. So that's what we're gonna focus on right now. You can see it on the screen, okay? And so you can also see a little sample of, pull that up, okay? Sample of my one I have in my three-ring binder. But let's just talk through this. How can you use this, okay? How can you use this? Well, I'm gonna write here on the screen. So right here, I have NACWI written down. Then I have topics written down here. Then I have experts right here. So I just go all the way along and I plan out what we're gonna be teaching for the whole year, for the whole year. I also write down events. Let's say this has events right here, okay? Then down here below, I talk about things for my Diane Cunningham brand, which I am Diane Cunningham, but underneath that would be the Brave Adventures, which there's Brave Adventures girls here in the room. We have travel and trips coming up this year. These are the women that are in my one-year program, okay? We also have the Hard Art Retreat. We had one in February, and we're having another one in October. So all of these things are listed out here on this page. How else could you use this brain board? I know a lot of you already use this, but you tell us in the chat room, how can you use this brain board? And there's all sorts of ways for you to use this. You can plan out your blogs. Okay, let me tell you how to do that right here. So let's say here we are in April. You're going to look ahead and go, okay, well, let's say you want to do two blogs a week. So you would just know, okay, you would say how many, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You would mark off and know what your topic was for April. And remember, I think, Karen, we talked about this. April is Stress Awareness Month, right? Bye, Anita. Love you. Talk to you later. So April is Stress Awareness Month. So Karen can use this month and do a blog. She's actually in the midst of a virtual book launch. Bravo, Karen. She wrote the book and she's promoting it, and I've got my own copy of it. I think it's in here, but I'm not going to go try to find it because I don't want my computer to run off. Okay. Yay, Karen. So she can do blogs and set it all up for all of April with the topics every single month. So there's many, many ways you can use this. I call it my brain board, and I make it big so that I can see it from across the room. Normally, it's not behind me. Normally, it's sitting right here. So when I'm teaching, when I'm coaching, when I'm on Facebook, I can look across, and I can add post-it notes, and I've used this over and over and over again for many, many years. And let's just have a teaching moment here. So basically, I just write on a post-it note the kind that are all the way sticky all the way through. And remember, this is the most important thing here at the top. His plan, not mine. His plan, not mine. His plan, not mine. Type that into the box for me. His plan, not mine. And then color code things. I need to add more stickies on here, okay? But I've been using this. This is just on a big board from the Hobby Lobby. We talked about that before. And I just got this one page blown up, and laminated, and stuck it on here. I've been using it probably long before I created NACWI. I've been using this thing. Okay? Is that helpful? Now that I've lost my computer screen, basically. Yay, Hobby Lobby. Okay, so let's keep going because I've got a lot more to teach. Get it done, trick number six, just for today. Okay, just for today trick. Now, this is how I've already mentioned this. I'm going to say it again. This is how I've stayed sober. And you know what? I'm coming around the bend to your birthday this summer, but that doesn't matter. It's today. Just for today. What do you need to do just for today? Just for today. There's a great poem that we shared yesterday in the NACWI group, and you just Google just for today, and it's a great little PDF. You can print it out. Just for today, I will try to live through this day only and not tackle all of my problems at once. I can do something for 12 hours that would appall me if I felt I had to keep it up for a lifetime. Just for today, I will be happy. This assumes to be true what Abraham Lincoln said, that most folks are as happy as they make up their minds to be. So I challenge each of you to just go Google just for today poem or just for today handout, just for today. It's from Al-Anon. And you know what? It works for all of us. So can you guys go do that? Will you accept that challenge? That's one of your pieces of homework for today. Just for today trick. So when you get all overwhelmed, when you get all in the fear later today, when you start having a little moment, freaking out, and think, oh my gosh, how am I going to get all this done? You're going to say, what do I need to do today? And you're going to quote me, tweet me, post me, tag me, whatever you got to do. Okay? Excellent. There's Callie sharing some other cool stuff. Okay, get it done trick number seven, make it fun trick. Make it fun. Make it fun. You can tell. I told you guys I was a fun friend. Well, hello. You guys got to see a little of my crazy today. I have red boas in here. I have painted hats. I have all sorts of goofy things in this office because you know what? My business has to be fun. If it's not fun, then I'm not adding myself into it. And so getting it done, make your thing fun. Make it fun. Figure out how you can add fun into your getting it done stuff. Does that make sense? If any of this, let me pause. If any of this is hitting home, any of this is making any sense, if you're getting any ideas that might be able to help you, give me a high five, okay? Because there's a lot of you out there, I'm hoping you're taking notes. Hopefully I haven't lost you when I like drop the computer off the chart. But if any of this is helpful to you, one tiny nugget can change everything. Make it fun. All right, let's talk about boundaries. Trips and ticks, trips and ticks, okay, miracles. We're going to call them boundary miracles. Okay, boundary miracle number one, time trade. I use this. Some of you might use this. There's other programs you can use. Doesn't matter what you use. This is $50 a year or so, and it's like changed my whole world. So set the boundaries, my friend. Set the boundary. Time trade. So that, well, how do I use that? Well, lots of times I only give the link. I have certain links to for my time. So I know what I'm doing at certain times. This is a sample one because I've got the big one over there. But I have time trade set up so my private clients can go in there and click the link and see when they can set up their next appointment. And when I say pre-qualify, what does that mean? Well, if somebody wants to coach with me, if they're interested in coaching with me, I used to just meet with anybody and everybody. I don't do that anymore because I spent many, many hours waiting on the telephones or waiting at coffee shops and somebody didn't show up or they weren't really ready. They weren't really ready. So I've learned by the hard way, which I think is the way all of us learn, to pre-qualify. So if you decide you want to coach with me, I send you to fill out a form. It's called Pick My Brain. So if you want to go see a great example of what I mean, just go to dianecunningham.com/pickmybrain. This is how I pre-qualify those that might want to coach with me. And it has saved my bacon, okay, because I need money to get the bacon so I can eat the bacon. The boundaries are that I pre-qualify somebody before we get on the phone because I need them to fill out that form and I need to see if they really are ready and if they're interested and if we're a good fit. And so then I send them the time trade link to set up that that consultation call. Okay, and I know ahead of time when those are going to be during my week. I know there are certain things I do every Monday. I meet with my NACWI team. I do conference planning. I send out certain emails. I do a lot of admin on Monday. Okay, and then on Tuesday, every Tuesday, I'm here with you guys on a cafe, on an expert, on a virtual networking. So everything is lined up, everything is set up in here. So we're already on to boundary miracle number two, and I already started talking about it. Time blocking. You've got to block off your time. You've got to block off your time. You've got to do right and left brain time. Now, hopefully you understand what I mean by that. I'm going to explain it real quick here. For me, right brain is creating things. It's writing. It's painting. It's like my heart pouring out on a page. That's right brain. That's the creative process for me. And left brain is like, we'll just say, sending out email newsletters, which is different. It's a writing, but it's a different writing. Okay. Left brain is taxes. Left brain is looking at my numbers for analytics, Google Analytics. We were talking about that yesterday on the team call, and it makes my brain kind of hurt, really. So that's left brain for me, left brain. So you got to block out your right brain and left brain stuff, because you know what? There's going to be some of that that's fun and some of that that's not fun. And if you want to have a business, you've got to do both. Does everybody understand that? If you want to be a businesswoman, you've got to have left brain time and right brain time, and you've got to do the business part too. The business part too. Okay. There's a lot of words that make me stutter. Boundaries miracle number three: delegation. A lot of the women that are part of my NACWI team, there's part of my team is on this training call right here, and then I have a NACWI team that's helping with the conference, a volunteer team. So one of the things you're going to have to do. Everybody write this in the room. Delegate. If you're still here, there's 28 of you here, I need you to type it into the room. Type. I need you to type in. Delegate. Type in let it go. Type in free yourself. Type in something. Because I need to know that you're here with me. Because you know what? You don't have to do it all. You do not have to do it all. You should not be doing it all. And you need to hire people to help you do it all. Let it go. You're going to tell me you don't have the money to do it. Okay, so I already hear you. You're talking. I can hear you. You might not, but you might. And you're going to have to decide what your hour is worth. And if that hour is better spent making you the money that you can do that person cannot do, then yes, you better be delegating. And you better delegate long before you think you can afford it. Okay, long before you think you can afford it, you've got to do it. And yes, you will be scared. And yes, you're going to survive. And yes, you're going to be uncomfortable. Hello, welcome to business. Welcome to entrepreneurship. Uncomfortable every single day. That's what we should call our cafe. We've got the rock bottom cafe, and then we've got the room for the fear inventory and the uncomfortable section. So you're going to delegate, and you're going to be able to ask people to help you. Boundaries miracle number four. Announcement to your tribe. And I'll explain what I mean by this. Closed sign, office hours, We Wednesday. Every Wednesday now, what we've been doing in our group is I announce it's We Wednesday. And I hand the baton to Kim or Callie or Sang or one of the team members that I have. They know what we do. They know the system. You guys have seen this. But that, guess what? That's my day to meet with my coach or to go do right brain stuff, to write the book, to write the program, to work on the sales page, to go hide at the day spa, which is sometimes where I go. That's what We Wednesday is about for me. It's my office hours. It's me saying, I'm closed. The shop is still open, but I am not here. I'm not here. I'm not going to answer your texts. I'm not going to answer your Facebook messages. I'm not here. So set the boundary by telling people when you work. Tell them that you don't reply after, you know, certain hours. I don't need to reply to Facebook messages at 7 o'clock at night when I'm walking through the Walmart. Hello? And I don't want you to expect me to read it and reply right then. You know, I am not a brain surgeon. And I am not going to be standing in the Walmart feeling like I have to reply to you. And you, I've had this happen before. This is why I'm saying it. Where I read the message. It was a business question. And I did not reply right then. And then the person said, why are you not replying? And I said, I am in the Walmart. So you know, we've got to set the boundary, and we've got to, like, just say, we've got to put the close sign up. So go ahead and just type into the room, office hours. Office hours. You are allowed to have them, and you need to have them, and you need to tell your people that you have them. Office hours. Okay? 750 words. This is another way that I have committed and set a boundary to write 750 words. For me, it sometimes is about signing up for something, even if it's a free system, but I'm so competitive that I want to, yes, you're allowed office hours. Like when I sign up for something, I'm so competitive that I do it. So just this last month, there's a couple of us that have been in this process. Go check out the website, 750words.com. This has helped me write 22,000 words last month, one day at a time, one word at a time. So if you've been on the 750 word bandwagon with me, go ahead and type that in there, 750. I mean, and I skipped 2 days. I gave myself 2 days off over the weekend, April 1st and 2nd. I could feel it. I could feel it. Shelly, you're so funny. Go run and do it. Come on back. I could feel it that I didn't write my 750, so I'm back on. Because you know what? I've got to take care of me. Part of me is pouring out the stuff that goes on up here and getting it out of my head onto pieces of paper, but more importantly, onto the keypad. Okay? So check that out. We're not going to go down that tangent. Okay. Tell people about your book, and these feel like they're sidetracks, but they're not. Basically, I'm talking about announcing to your tribe. I've announced to you that there's the next Brave book is coming out. I announced that to you in the Brave group, and I've been announcing it, and hopefully you guys can't hear. They're mowing the lawn right outside the window here. Tell people about your book. Tell people about your event. Tell people about your retreat, because that's you making a commitment out loud in front of your people, which forces me to do it. Okay? Does that make sense? Boundary miracle number 5. Phone and email. Okay. 2 places you need to write down: Google Voice. So somebody write this down. Google Voice. Type that into the box. You need Google Voice or some other phone system. I do not give out my cell phone number unless you're my private client. Because you know what? I don't need any crazy people calling me in the middle of the night or on the weekend asking me those Facebook type questions. Okay, Google Voice. It's a free system, free program, and it sets the boundary. That's the phone number that's on my website, on my business card, everywhere. And it comes into my telephone, but it also sends me a text and it sends me an email, and I can reply. So it's very, very cool. Set the boundary. I don't answer my phone unless I have a client that I'm meeting on the phone. And we actually meet on a conference call line. Okay? So that's one of my phone boundaries. Email. I don't check my email from my phone. I don't check it ever on my phone. And that's just my boundary. I've used Grasshopper in the past. My boundary is I check email constantly right here all day long. So when I leave the house, I don't need to be checking the email here. Oh, no. No, no. I'm done with that. So decide what your own phone and email boundaries are. Okay? Decide what they are and then just commit to them. Because you know what? The world does go on. I have found that out. You know, a lot of you check your email from your phone. The world goes on for you. The world goes on for me, and I don't. You know, some of you have your regular phone on your website, and I don't. That's okay. The world will go on. So just decide what works for you, for your family, for your future. Because remember, let's say you have 5 clients right now. What if you have 500 clients? Grasshopper is another phone system. But you have to pay for that. That's a paid Grasshopper. It's like an answering machine that you can have different, you can have an answer for different people. So I could have a phone number for Callie. I could have a phone number for Kim on there. I did that in the past. So that's what Grasshopper is. Good question. The secret wisdom. So that's the last. So we had 7 get it done tricks. We're coming towards the end of the webinar here. So just come with me. Everybody still here? Give me a high five. I gotta take a drink. Woo! I know. I feel like you guys can see up my nose. High five. Woo-wee! We have 5 boundary setting techniques. So let me pause here. What boundary do you need to set? Let me ask you some questions while I regroup. What boundary do you need to set? Hello, this is your turn. I've been teaching and sharing and giving. What boundary do you need to set today, like today? Today. What boundary do you need to set? What boundary do you need to change? What thing do you need to switch? What phone number do you need to get? What system do you need to, like, cancel? Office hours, yes, hello. Great, Teresa. Shelby. Google Voice, amen. Time blocking, good. Okay, what else? Who is, like, what do you need to commit to? What do you need to commit to right now in front of everybody? Right now, this very minute, while I'm asking, this is coaching. This is coaching. Brain board, time blocking, Google Voice. So you keep typing. If there's something that hit you, the brain board, the time block, the Google Voice, the pre-qualifying, some of these things you've heard about a bunch of times. You just need to do it. You just have to do it. 750, yes. It'll change your world. Okay, excellent. Good, good, good. Mm-hmm. Yes, action. So here's the secret wisdom. The secret wisdom of accountability, 90 days, and systems. All of these things are proven, and we've all done them, but you need to look back on your own story, okay? So my story is that basically, and I'm going to use a specific example that does not have anything to do with business. I'm going to talk about my recovery. I'm very vocal about my recovery, so if this is brand new for you, just bear with me. But I'm in recovery, and I hit rock bottom from alcoholism, and I wrote a book about it, and so it's out there. It's on YouTube. We've got 3 books. Go to Rock Bottom. It's a beautiful place. If you're a rock bottom sister, I know we've got a bunch of you in the house. If you're a rock bottom girl that's written their story, I know some of you are here, so go ahead and type into the box, rock bottom sister. Yay! So basically, I hit rock bottom, and when I went walking into my first AA meeting, they suggested I go to 90 meetings in 90 days. Now, when you first hear that, you freak out. I'll just be honest, because I thought, oh my gosh, what does that even mean? Who has time for that? You know, I have a business, and I've got all this stuff going on, and book launches, and this and that and the other. Well, guess what? You know, we have time for what we make time for. We have time for what we make time for. And so I really want to challenge you to the fact that in the next 90 days, you could change your entire world. You can change your entire world. You can create systems. You could do 750 words every single day. And like I just did, I did 22,000 words in my first 30 days of that. And I created my own process. I learned from my own story. I was accountable to myself. So what do you need to do? What can you change and do it one day at a time? Maybe just in 30-day, 60-day, 90-day blocks. Okay? You have a story, and just like mine, it's going to make sense to you. It's going to make sense to you to do something new and make a commitment. We don't learn something overnight, and we don't ever graduate. That's the other part. You know, when I first walked in those doors, I thought, okay, I'm just going to whip through these steps, 12 steps. You know, how hard can it be, right? Well, it's very hard, and it's very easy at the same time. It's a way of learning how to live. And if you want to be in business, you're probably not just in business for 90 days. You're probably not going to learn everything you need to know in a one-hour webinar, right? You're probably going to be, I mean, a lot of you I've known for what, 6 years, 5 years, 3 years, 2 years? We've known each other a long time. And we show up. We do the next right thing. We work. We do the deal. And here, let me just show you my next screen. The bottom line. Here's the bottom line, my friends. Stop talking. Sit your butt down in the seat and do the work. Bottom line. Stop talking. Sit down and do the work. Do the work. Do the work. Are you doing the work? That's my big question for you today. Are you doing the work, or are you shuffling the papers around? The butt in the seat, yes. I've got my butt in the seat. And so these are questions that you have to ask yourself, but I'm going to go back to that first A word that we talked about. The A word was accountability, that one. I know for me, I have a private coach. I've had a private coach for years, and I will always have a private coach now, because I need the accountability. I need the accountability to, because I meet with her tomorrow, so I've got to send in my update, my report, my questions, my stuff. And I pay for the accountability. I think that that's important. That's important for me because, you know, what we pay for, we value. So I'm going to challenge you to find the accountability that you need. Let's go back to the screen. Find the accountability that you need, somebody that's going to love you and give you some kicks in the behind when you need that. Get your butt in the seat, ask you what you've done, and basically give you homework. Bye, Donna. See you guys later. I know some of you have to leave. We're almost done. So, okay, let's finish up. Creativity circle. I show this a lot. I'm just going to show it real quickly again. Every single thing that we've talked about today, this is how you're going to do them. This is how you're going to do these things. A book, the program, the coaching, the speaking. You're going to do it one day at a time. You're going to offer it by creating it, and then you're going to create it and see what works. Okay? You're going to see what works. What is the story you are telling yourself? I drew this out back in, and actually Marcia and Karen were here at my house when we did this. What is the story you are telling yourself? Are you telling yourself you don't have enough time? And guess what? You have 24 hours just like me. Are you telling yourself that you don't have enough money? Are you telling yourself that you can't be accountable because of blank, blank, and blank? What are you telling yourself? What is the story? Somebody type this out for me. What is the story that you are telling yourself that you decide to change today? Because guess what? You can. You can change your own story today. The day that I stood up in a room and I said I was the founder and president of the National Association of Christian Women Entrepreneurs, I had no members. I had no website. I had nothing except me saying it, changing my own story so that I could change yours. Isn't that amazing? Isn't that amazing? Change your story today, sister. What do I see most in all of you? I see you thinking you don't know enough. I see you thinking you don't have enough. And I see you thinking you are not enough. And it's all lies. It's all lies. What will you get done? Here's my questions for you today, and then I'll give you a opportunity, and then we're going to close in prayer. Yay. What will you get done today? And feel free to in our send me an email, post on my page, do whatever you got to do because, you know, for me, I've got to say it. What will you get done today? Like as in before you get into the bed. What will you do by the end of today? What will you complete by this Friday? Say it, speak it, share it. What is your goal for April? What did you do in the first quarter? I mean, we just finished the first quarter, and now we're into the second quarter of the year. I don't know where it went, but it goes fast. How will you reach your next 90-day goals? How will you do it? How will you do it? There is no magic pill. I don't have one. I hope, you know, and I don't know if you do or not, but I don't have one. My magic pill is my butt in the seat. And it is always, 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 no matter what, one day at a time. It's going to be one day at a time in love. It's going to be one day at a time if you're raising a child. It's going to be one day at a time if you're, living free from an addiction. That's all we've got, baby cakes. It's all we've got, and it's a gift. It's a gift. These are my sisters. These are all of us last year at the conference, and cannot wait. Because I get to gather up with a lot of these ladies again. There's Marcia. If anybody else is in this picture that is here on the webinar, Karen, I think she had to leave maybe. But basically, we're getting together in 23 days. Yay! There's Callie. Oh, yeah, there's Callie. Awesome, awesome. I love you guys. And we get to gather up in 23 days. So here's my invitation. Come join us. You know, we have this kind of crazy kooky stuff go on webinars, but we do it in person. And so if you join us, when you join us, let me say it that way, when you join us, you're going to access us, me, all of us, virtual networking parties. We have those twice a month. You're going to get yourself a business listing on our directory. You're going to be able to come to the conference, which starts here on the 28th of April, very soon. You're going to get daily coaching questions. Basically, you're going to have access to all of this, the 19 classrooms, the virtual conference in the fall, expert training, all of these things, weekly prayer call. I could go on and on. Yes, yes, yes. And it's $497 for the premium membership. This is such a great deal. You have no idea. This is such a great deal. I pay thousands and thousands of dollars for my coaching every year. Thousands. Thousands and thousands of dollars for my coaching and to pay my team and to do the things so that I can help you guys. I invest in myself every single month so much, so much. I hope you invest in yourself. I hope that you choose. I hope that you decide. You can pay in full or two parts. We also have a deluxe membership. Some of you are that. Some of you have that. And that includes, guess what? That includes two really amazing programs too. The Create Your Association program. Thank you, Shelby. Thank you, Pam. Yay! And the Create Christian Women's Leadership Institute. If you're already at the 497 level and you want to upgrade, just let us know. These are two huge programs where I teach you how to create your own tribe. Okay? Teach you how to create your own tribe and also train you how to become a certified group facilitator and lead your own groups. It's a big deal. So here's the special offer. And I know we're past time, so I got to finish up. If you take action, because that's what we talked about, action takers win, by midnight, which is tomorrow, Wednesday the 6th, you're going to get a special bonus group power hour, 1 hour, 60 minutes live with me and whoever else joins. And 5 getting it done bonus templates, but you have to join us by tomorrow night, by the end of tomorrow night. But the sooner you join, the sooner you get in the group. Hello. So I hope you do. I hope you take some action. I hope you decide. I hope you make a move because you're worth it. Because you're worth it. That's the truth of the matter. You're totally worth it, my friend. You're totally worth it. You deserve to be with us and have the support that you need so that you can move forward. All right, let me close in prayer. Father God, thank you. I know we've gone over today, and Lord, I know we've had a bunch of crazy that went on, but Lord, thank you for helping me to just be me and to do that and not be afraid, to not worry that they are going to run off. And Lord, if they run off, Lord, that's your will. That's your will. Lord, thank you for teaching me to not try to prove myself to anyone over and over again. Lord, that the right ones come. Lord, I pray that everyone here is blessed. I pray that they got one nugget of information that they will be able to use today. Lord, I pray that they were inspired by something, that they will take action. They will invite accountability into their life, and that they will do whatever the next right thing is for them to build their business, because then, guess what? They can reach more people. It's not about us. Lord, remind us of that every day when we get caught up in overwhelm and perfectionism. It's not about us. Most of it doesn't really matter. We just need to serve the world. Lord, thank you for reminding me of that today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. It's not about us. You are worth it, sister. Okay. I'm going to download this, upload this, get it to YouTube, and do all the things I do. I will meet you guys over on the flip side on Facebook World. And love you all. See you soon. See you at our conference in 23 days. Hello. Bye.